Look up at the sky. Millions of years ago, it wasn't filled with birds. Instead, the air belonged to monsters with wings as wide as a house, shadows that could swallow the land below. These were the pterosaurs, rulers of the prehistoric skies. The largest of them all, Quetzalcoatlus, was a flying giant unlike anything alive today. On the ground, it stood taller than a giraffe. In the air, its wings stretched nearly 40 feet, wide enough to block out the sun. It could glide for miles, scanning the world below, before plunging down with terrifying speed. Small dinosaurs, reptiles, even early mammals, nothing was safe when this hunter cast its shadow. But the skies weren't ruled by one creature alone. There were flocks of smaller pterosaurs darting through the air like fighter jets, snapping up insects mid-flight. And the insects? Forget the tiny ones you see today. These were dragonflies the size of seagulls, with wings that buzzed like engines, filling the air with their swarm. The prehistoric skies were never calm. Storms rolled across the land, turning the air into chaos. Volcanic ash darkened the horizon, choking the atmosphere and forcing creatures to battle the winds for survival. One wrong move and a giant predator could be slammed to the ground. Above forests, coastlines, and rivers, the skies were alive with hunters. Some pterosaurs skimmed the waves, snatching fish with needle-like jaws. Others soared above the trees, waiting to dive on prey below. To live in this world meant one thing: master the skies or vanish forever. For millions of years, these winged giants owned the skies. They were faster, larger, and deadlier than anything flying today. Every shadow overhead carried fear, and every flight was a battle to survive. In the next episode, we step into the forests of giants, where plants grew taller than skyscrapers and creatures lived in shadows as strange as the skies above. Don't miss it. Subscribe now and keep traveling back in time.